But we start with the latest on last night's bus crash. We're getting our first look at the driver. This is 52-year-old Quentin Watts of Stockton, who is in critical condition and under arrest for DUI. Here are the updated numbers. 8 people died in the crash. The other 35 people on board suffered minor to major injuries. The owner of the bus company was among those killed. Let's show you again where this all happened. The bus was traveling from Sacramento to the Calusa Casino. It had exited I-5 and was traveling north on Lone Star Road, crashing near Highway 20 in Calusa County, east of Williams. We have live team coverage tonight. Rich Ibarra is in Stockton looking into the bus driver. Suzanne Fahn is in Sacramento, where she's been talking to the victim's family members. But we start with Tom Duhane live in Williams. Tom?
And right now I'm outside of a tow yard in Williams, and behind me you can see the wreckage of the bus, at least what remains of it. It's pretty frightening. We're looking at the front of the bus, and imagine that the driver managed to at least come out alive. He is in critical condition. We don't know if he's going to survive, though. As you mentioned, 43 people were on board. 8 of those have died. All the other 35 were all injured. Half of them had to be airlifted to trauma centers in serious or critical condition. Here now, the very latest on the investigation.
First thing this morning, a CHP accident investigation team was crawling over, under, around, and through the wreckage of the 1993 model MCI bus. They are especially interested in evidence showing the mechanical condition of this bus.
It's going to take a long time to gather all of the data, to interview the majority of all of the witnesses, as well as put together a reconstruction of it. We're going to certainly do it as quickly as we can. However, it's going to take some time.
The CHP will also examine the condition of the roadway and the condition of the driver. In this case, 52-year-old Quentin J. Watts, who remains in critical condition at Woodland Memorial Hospital. He was arrested at his bedside for DUI, driving under the influence of alcohol or drugs or both. The arrest is based on the eyewitness observation of an off-duty Calusa sheriff deputy. About 5:30 this morning, the damaged coach was carefully lifted from the muddy field that it crashed in. That after a careful overnight search for additional victims who might be hidden by the darkness.
By the way, that sheriff deputy saw the vehicle swerve to one side, swerve to the other, overcorrect, lose control, then flip over into the ditch. CHP says a complicated investigation like this is likely to take 6 to 9 months, but it will be given high priority. And again, as we said, at this point, the blame falls squarely on the driver so far for a DUI. But so far, the CHP is saying very little about what they know. The biological test, the blood test, or the toxicology is not back yet. The arrest was made based on the swerving and the unusual driving that was observed at the scene just before the crash. Reporting live, I'm Tom Duhane. Back to you.
All right, Tom. Thanks.